Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Daniel Rosal here. So today I want to cover a topic that I think might be of interest for anybody starting out with a YouTube channel, or like me, they're starting with really basic, budget-friendly, rudimentary kit, but they're starting to get more advanced and you want to connect external accessories to your camcorder, but there's only one problem, and that's that your camcorder doesn't have any shoes on it. So an example of such a camcorder is the one I'm holding right here, the Canon Vixia HF R800, and it doesn't have any shoe fitting. So before I go any further, let me just explain, just to cover this, what a shoe is. So a shoe is basically a standard type of connection that you'll see in camcorders, on mirrorless cameras, on DSLR cameras. And basically it's this little, if I can just get it out from this accessory I was using to demonstrate, this is what a shoe is. It's a little attachment that has a little opening here, and an accessory that has a shoe fitting basically typically has a square at the bottom. That's because the shoe socket has a square to go into it. And the way this works is you just push an accessory with a shoe fitting. And then they usually have this little locking ring so that you can make sure that your lights, your expensive lights and microphones and whatever else you're connecting to a shoe fitting is secure and doesn't fall off when your camcorder is moving about in whatever environment you're in. Now, that's what shoes are. There's two types of shoes, just to finish off this intro. There's cold shoes and hot shoes. The difference is that a cold shoe is just basically a piece of plastic or metal. It's just a physical connection into which you can connect anything that takes a shoe. A hot shoe has a circuitry on the shoe. So not only will you physically tether something, if you have an accessory with a hot shoe and you put that into a hot shoe mount, then you don't need to have any wires. The accessory can actually communicate with your camcorder at the shoe fitting. So that's really useful if you have such accessories. Now what happens if, as in this situation, your camera doesn't have a shoe? So all hope is not lost is the good news. The bad news is that I think it's definitely better if you want to start working with accessories, it's better to get a camcorder with at least one cold shoe. And the reason I say at least with one cold shoe is because of the way that there are so many brackets and adapters, once you've one cold shoe, you can expand out of that and get yourself more accessories connected. But if you don't have any, even to start with, that becomes pretty much impossible. So if I were buying a camcorder again, I bought this camcorder because it had an external mic input, but I would definitely look for a camcorder with at least one cold shoe on it. Now, I just want to show you guys a few different things I've bought to work around this issue. So the first thing that I picked up was this L bracket. Now, these are all pretty much the same. There's a few different types available on Amazon, B&H, and other camera stores. To be honest, they all look almost identical. And the concept here is that you'll take your camera, it's got a little sliding rail with a 1/4-inch screw. Now here's my hack. I added a couple of washers just between the 1/4-inch screw and the sliding rail. And the reason I did that was I had this attached to a monopod. And when I had this, when I put in the monopod and screwed this into my camcorder, it actually ended up over tightening the screw to the point that I had to use a vise, as you can see from the fact this is all scratched up, to actually get the screw open. So you don't want to do that. So I went to my hardware store and he just sold me a bag of washers, and I just stuck a couple under here, and that solved the problem. I can now tighten this really, really well, but the screw doesn't get stuck, which is what was happening before. So basically, this device is almost self-explanatory, but you can use it in two ways. You've got a hand grip and you have a couple of cold shoes here. So the way you use this is, you know, the classic way would be using it in its L-shape configuration. So I'm just gonna screw in the bracket to the camcorder. Now I have my camera secure. I've got this nice little hand grip here, and I've got two shoes, and into those shoes I can put, let's say firstly, my mini light. I have it on the little shoe adapter. And I can put my mini light, and I can also put the shotgun microphone, and that'll allow me to use an external microphone. Now, if a camcorder doesn't have a cold shoe, it doesn't have a hot shoe, but if it did have a hot shoe on it, you could connect stuff directly. What I'll do here is let's say I want to put the microphone here and the camera here, And then I just can open up like this and just connect in my microphone, bringing the cable around the back. And now I have an external microphone and a light on a cold shoe. Now this is kind of cumbersome, to be honest, but at least it's better than not being able to use any external microphone. Now, another good thing about these brackets is that they have a, it's a actually a male to female quarter inch thread. So what you can do is put this rig up on a monopod or on a tripod. So the setting I was using at a march I went to last week was that I had the L bracket on a monopod, and that way I was able to use the light like so and use the microphone, and I could also get this set up 1.5 meters into the air, which was kind of nice. So yeah, everything's very interchangeable. For instance, at the bottom of this, the monopod, I've actually added here another type of bracket, which I will just show you. So that you have a few options. That's the L bracket. You also have C brackets. And you know, whichever one you use really depends on your preference, because of the fact that I really want to use all these accessories I've bought. I kind of went a bit maybe OTT and bought a bunch of different kinds, which is why I have all these ones to show you. So that's number one. Number two, option two, is you can just use something simpler like this. Now this doesn't have shoes, it's just a simple piece of metal that has a quarter inch thread here. So you can put this on, again, your monopod or your tripod, and you've got two quarter inch threads here that'll lock in. So you could have, let's say, a camera here, you could have a webcam if your webcam has a tripod thread, and you could have a light or something like that here. That's an option. A lot of stuff I bought from Ulanzi, including these two pieces I'm going to show you. This one has a quarter inch here and a shoe, a cold shoe here. So this is kind of my daytime recording adapter when I don't have a requirement to use any additional lighting. So just to give you guys an example, the way I would use this would be to put, this actually has a shoe on it as well. I could connect the monopod into this adapter, then connect the camcorder into the quarter inch here. And it's just got kind of one of these, you know, easy locking mechanisms. If I can get it to work momentarily. This one I've had a bit of trouble with. It doesn't like stay. There's a little bit of there's flexibility here, which I'm not sure that's intentional. I can't tighten this any further. And there's a cold shoe here, so I could put my, you know, this guy here, the microphone, and then tighten that in. So that's another type of adapter. If you go onto AliExpress or Amazon or eBay, you'll see tons and tons of Ulanzi adapters. They have a gigantic catalog, and I've bought quite a few of these things just to find various ways to set up rigs. So those are options one, two, and three. Just a couple more to show you before I end this video. Another option you have, now this is why I said at the start of the video, this is the Ulanzi PT1, that once you have one cold shoe, you can do a lot. You can kind of split stuff off from it. So this guy is an example of what I'd use this for. You could have your camcorder here, but it's a bit tight. What this is really designed for is gimbals. So if you have a gimbal, let's just pretend this monopod is a gimbal. So like most monopods or gimbals, it has a quarter inch fitting at the bottom. So what you can do is, now these are generally called like flap brackets. So I've just screwed that in, and now I have, just going out a couple of inches, a triple 1-3 cold shoe adapter. So, you know, if I wanted to rig up a microphone here, if I wanted to get my little mini light onto it, then I could do that, because if you're working with the gimbal, the balance and calibration is very sensitive. So generally, from what I understand, most people will want to be connecting their accessories not on the gimbal itself, but just a little bit offset. So for instance, like something like this, and I could just run the microphone up into the camcorder or into the phone or whatever the case was, and just have it out to the side. So you can find these all really easily on the internet, as I said. I'm almost done. Two more things to show in my shoeless camera show and tell day. So this is a handy piece of kit. This is another Ulanzi piece, and what I like about this one is it's a 1-3 cold shoe adapter. So you've got your cold shoe slash quarter inch here, and you've got three shoes here. What I like about this piece is the fact that these are all rotatable. So I'll just give you an example of what you could do. And while I'm at it, I'll show you one more piece. You can go from a quarter inch to a shoe. You'll find pieces like that. I don't have one in front of me. And you can also find these little adapters to go from a shoe to a quarter inch. So this has a cold shoe here, and it's got two nuts here. So what I could do is put this into this 1-3 adapter, use the bottom locking ring to secure this here, put this down temporarily, put the camcorder here, and just secure this better, but you get the idea. And then put this guy up to lock in the camera. Then I would have these two shoes. Now I'll tell you why this is really useful. Let's just say my camcorder, you know what, I'll go ahead and do it. I'm not gonna do all these connections super perfect, but hopefully good enough to demonstrate. So my camcorder is up on this guy now, and this is why this is a Ulanzi, PT something or other. So I'm gonna hold it because it's not very securely attached. And I can put the microphone into one of these cold shoes here, secure it. But what I like about this particular adapter is that these can all be rotated. So I can rotate the microphone around. Now, I didn't do this very well, but you get the idea. It's lockable. I should have put the stuff, it's on the wrong side. But this is useful, for instance, if you're recording, you're using a directional microphone like the shotgun. Sometimes you're recording this way, and other times you want to be doing, you know, you're narrating to the camera as you record, so you want to pick up audio from this side, so you can just swivel it around. Final piece is the grip. So this is kind of a classic poor man stabilizer. Now obviously this isn't comparable in any way to a proper stabilization system or a gimbal. I've actually not succeeded, and I've been trying very hard to find a gimbal for this camcorder. The shape just seems to be a sticking point. I've been to like 6 camera stores in my area, and they've all told me to get lost basically. But this is, you know, this kind of does a little bit of stabilization. So it's a C grip or a U grip. You'll find these sometimes called C grips, sometimes called U grips. You'll find these very easily on Amazon. It's got a little quarter inch thread on a rail here. So what you want to do is, these are a bit finicky. They tend to kind of get stuck, but secure your device, whether it's a DSLR, a mirrorless camcorder, onto the rail. And then you've got 1, 2, 3 shoes up the top to fit your devices to. And as I said before, the beauty of the shoe world, if you will, is that everything's so interchangeable. So there's nothing stopping you from, let's say, fitting this 1-3 cold shoe bracket here. Now I can put 3 lights up the top, and I can put a microphone up the side, microphone back, monitor. I can put another 3 brackets. You get the idea. You can mix and match to your heart's content. Caveat being, of course, that the more accessories you're adding, and the more weight you're accumulating, if you use the more weight's going to be on your hands when you end up holding it, especially if you're using something like a gimbal. So I hope that overview is helpful. I know I went into a lot of detail. That's primarily because I've spent a lot of time over the last 2 weeks ordering these things and trying to figure out the various ways I could connect things with. I definitely think these things are kind of handy to have in your video cabinet or your vlogging drawer, whatever you want to call it. Much more ideal to just have a shoe on your camcorder. If this camera had just one cold shoe at the front, you know, I could get away with mostly just having a microphone mounted, and that is a lot easier to fit back into a bag than having to put this big bracket out and back every time. So that's a bit of a nuisance. But in any event, there at least are a couple of options if you have a camcorder without any shoes and you want to use different accessories. Thank you guys for watching. Hope this was helpful.